Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. In this episode, I'm going to be showing you how to configure your microphone in Windows 10. I've shown you how to do it in XP. I've shown you how to do it in Windows 7. If you could do it in Windows 7, you could do it in Windows 10. There's only a couple little minor changes, but why not do it? Anything you can do to get that little extra gain of boost or to be able to choose your sound source, it just makes it better when you're doing recording. You know me. I like to make videos. I like to help people make videos. So what we're going to do is show you how to tweak your system so you're going to get the best out of it. And hopefully,
first thing we need to do is to be able to get to our microphone settings. Click here and I type to search and I start typing in the word control. And boom, control panel. I'm there. Hardware and sound. Sound. And recording. That's one way. Second way to get there is, see the little speaker icon here? Right click on it and choose your recording devices. And you'll see I'm right back exactly where I need it to be. What I like to do is I disable the devices that I don't use. I actually enabled a couple of extra here just to show you for the example. So my Razer Kiyo, the mic on that, I don't use it. My Samsung Go mic is my microphone of choice. If you can choose a USB or analog, right, that's your little 3.5 millimeter pin connector, go with a USB mic. It's going to give you less problems. Also, the difference that you're going to notice, okay, this is a USB mic. Click on properties and levels. This is what you want. Levels, this is where you can control your gain. On my USB mic, especially the Go mic, I had to decrease the gain. But let's look at this one. This is the one built into my sound card and it's analog. This is the one where you have the boost. I click on it, I choose properties, and I look at levels, and this is my boost. And I gotta kick this bad boy up if I'm gonna wanna get some type of sound. So if you're using a traditional microphone that you jacked into the back of your computer or the front, non-USB, go to your microphone boost and kick it up. And that's going to give you the gain that you need. If you're streaming games, then go with your headset, because this puts the mic right at your mouth and you can hear what's going on through your headset. Here's another problem that people come and I see. It's your microphone drivers. How do you get the proper drivers for your sound card? Most people, unfortunately, if you have an older system, Windows says, hey, or Microsoft says, I have drivers for you. Let me use my drivers. They're more current. The problem is that the Microsoft drivers, while they work, when it comes to sound, they're going to give you the most headache. So what I recommend is go to the manufacturer who makes your system. So if you had a HP, like my wife has, you go to the HP website. If you don't have an HP, you built it yourself, or you just don't know, or HP says there are no drivers, you need to go to the manufacturer of the sound card. How do you find out what that is? This PC, right click, choose properties and device manager. Under device manager, I scroll down to sound. Here they are. Right here, my Realtek high definition audio. That's telling me I have a Realtek sound card, or the chip is Realtek. I go to their website and download their drivers. The manufacturer drivers are always going to be better than the Microsoft drivers, and that's what you want to use. If you don't use those, then certain things like your gain will actually disappear. Another thing that you could use if you're having problems with your device, you can go to configure and this window pops up and I can click on setup microphone. That will take you through the steps. But more times than not, people who are having problems getting their sound card to work, it's because you're using the Microsoft drivers or you don't have under levels. You just don't have the gain kicked up to where it needs to be. Another thing I like to do is I take the devices that I don't use, like this one, I right click on it and I disable it. If you're not using it, why have it enabled? It's only going to give you headache later on down the line. Well, that's really the basics you need to know for getting your microphone to work using Windows 10. I hope you found this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza useful. Again, I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. and thank you for watching. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe and leave comments below. If I can help you, I will. And if there's other videos you'd like to see, let me know what you want to see. I'll make them. If I got the stuff, I'll do it. Thanks again for watching. Have a good day.
All right, ready, Oreo? Catch. Good.